Today I'm going to teach you how to make your very own hi-fi amplifier. Now I've already taught you how to make your own hi-fi speaker wire and speakers, so this seems like the next logical step. Now this same amplifier either has been or is currently sold by the likes of Seymour AV, Rotel, PS Audio, Bowers & Wilkins, Bang & Olufsen, Bel Canto, Wired for Sound, and so many more companies that I can't even think of right off the top of my head. Best part is you can make this exact same amplifier for a fraction of the cost that it would take you to buy it with that name on it. And you don't even need to mess with a big power supply as it's all built into the amplifier itself. Instead, you just get a very easy to make, great sounding, low distortion amplifier that looks as good as it sounds. Now the reason most people don't take on this project is there's very little documentation on how to properly wire it, and these boards have been very hard for consumers to get their hands on. And even today, the only place you can actually buy these boards in the United States is from Parts Express. But now that you can get these boards, all you need to do is learn how to wire it. Luckily, that's what I'm going to teach you today. By the time you're done watching this video, you're going to be able to make this exact same hi-fi amplifier that sells for the upwards of $3,000 for around $300. And I am going to try to simplify it so that any of you can do it at home today. Having said that, I'm not responsible if you do wire this incorrectly. Always check your documentation and consult an expert if you feel like you need to. All right, guys, I need to take a quick moment to apologize for the soon-to-be confusion. The rest of this video, I started calling the 200 ASC module the 200 ASP and the 200 AC module the 200 AS. So you're going to hear that a lot in the next couple minutes. I just don't want you to be confused. Now, if you really want to make fun of me and you want to pay attention to how many times I messed up, go ahead and comment in the comment section below on how many times I said the wrong words. Thanks, guys. Now, let's get back to the building. Now, there are a few things you're going to need for this project. The first is, of course, an amplifier case. You're going to need the amplifier boards, the cables needed to hook them up, and a soldering iron. Now in this video, I'm going to show you how to hook up a 200 ASP board to a 200 AS to make a dual mono block amplifier. Now before I do that, let's talk a little bit about the boards themselves. This is the 200 ASP. You see, this board actually has a built-in power supply that can power not only itself, but up to two additional AS modules. Now the AS modules are cheaper since they need the ASP in order to run. Like I previously mentioned, today I'm going to show you how to hook up a two-channel setup. All the parts I use will be linked down in the description of the video. Make sure to check it out. Now, if you want more power, there will be links to the 500 and 1000 watt versions of this amplifier as well. All right, now that we've covered the amplifier boards, let's talk a little bit about the case. Now, you can go out and buy a case and even get one machined for you, but you would have to drill out all the holes and buy all the feet and all the other components. What I recommend you do is actually buy a case like this from Ghent Audio, which is what I did. See, the screw holes are already drilled, it comes with all the connections you need, and it can even come with all the cables as well if you pick that kit. Now this is the kit that I picked, and this is the kit that I'm going to show you how to build today. And although all the wires come with this kit, there are some wires that I do prefer from Parts Express, and we will talk about those when we get to them. Let's go ahead and open up the amplifier case and show you how to wire everything. Now the first thing that you're going to want to do is hook up the power button. Now the power button goes to the very front of the amplifier unit. It uses two standoffs. Just run those two standoffs in the front and start to screw that down. Now it is going to use one other standoff, which is going to go through the bottom of the case. The bottom of the case has a bunch of different screw holes. Now one thing you're going to want to be made aware of is that these screw holes are made for all kinds of different boards that can fit inside this particular case. So you're not going to be using all the holes on here. So go ahead and check to see where this power button actually fits and where the hole lines up. It is only one spot on the case. Now once you get that lined up and you have the power button installed, you're also going to want to install the power socket on the back of the amplifier. Now we could go ahead and start hooking up power right now, but that really doesn't make sense because I think we should first hook up the amplifier board. Now I already mentioned that there are a bunch of screw holes on the bottom. Keep in mind the ASP module is going to be towards the front of the amplifier, and that module can only go in one direction. If you notice, there are actually five screw holes on here. There's one right here in the middle section. That will only line up one way on this amplifier case. Now, I mentioned that to you because it is different, at least mine was different than what it showed on the internet. Now, as soon as you figured out the orientation, figure out what screw holes you're going to need to put standoffs in and start installing the standoffs. Now, after you've done that, go ahead and do the 200AS as well. Follow the same orientation that I installed it in. Now, the first thing that we're gonna do is hook up the power. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and hook up this black and red cable that goes directly from the power button all the way to the power socket. Now, if you take a look at it, mine says the black over here by the power button says N by it. Now, that stands for neutral. You're gonna plug that up to the neutral. You're also gonna plug the red up to the L, which stands for line. Now, this yellow one is gonna plug up to the earth, but you're gonna notice that it has a spot underneath that it's supposed to be screwed onto. Now, this is where one of the feet come into play. So now, go ahead and take out your feet and install the 3 feet besides that one. Now, the one by the power socket has a little bit different of a screw. You may notice that one of those is silver. We're gonna run that silver one through here, and we're just gonna tighten down the nut up top, and that's gonna ground that for us to the amplifier chassis. All right, so we have our main power going to our power switch. Now we need it to go from the power switch to the amplifier board. Now that's great, because this is also a very easy connection. The wire's already pre-made for us, so we just plug it into the power switch, run it along the front, and plug it into P1 on the ASP board. Now there's only one other thing that we need to hook up to this power switch, which is the LED light. What we're gonna wanna do is plug up that little wire, which is red and gray. Now if we look at the power button, once again, it's gonna show red is positive and gray is negative. We're gonna run that to the jumper connectors right next to that P1. There's a 3-wire JST terminal there. We are actually only gonna be using 2 of those wires. The red wire, which is the far right wire for me, is going to be cut off. Instead, I'm gonna be using the white and the black. We're gonna take the white wire and hook it up to the red wire. Now that gray one from the power switch is gonna be hooked up to the black, which is your ground. All right, now the LED is actually completely wired up, but in order to get it to work right, we are gonna have to do one other thing. Now, this is where I really like this cable that you can get from Parts Express. This is just a jumper cable that's gonna be connecting right in between bay 4 and 5 on the ASP board. Once you have that connected, you actually have your LED hooked up. Let's go ahead and finish hooking up power. If you go to the back of the 200 ASP towards the rear of the amplifier, you're going to see a small power connector there. And if you installed the 200 AS like I told you to, you're gonna notice also a plus and minus 47 volt that's gonna be very close to it. Just go ahead and plug up the power cable to that. It's a very short cable and it will just snap right into place. It has both ends on it. Really, honestly, we're almost done hooking up this amplifier. So with this next terminal is called J3 on the ASP board. Now there are 8 different wires connected to this J3 terminal. We are not gonna be using 4 and 5, so I'm just gonna cut those off. Now for me, that was a purple and a green wire. The first 3 we are going to be using. Now, we're gonna be hooking that up to J3 on the AS module. Now, this is where it can get kind of confusing, because if you're used to just like color coordinating, these wires don't actually hook up color coordinating at all. We have a black, a gray, and a red on the ASP, and we have a purple, a red, and a black. The most important thing is for you to make sure that you hook these up in the right direction. Now, these are plus and minus 12 volts as well as a ground. Now, ground, according to both my manuals, is going to be the middle wire. Now, that is black on the AS board, and that's a gray wire, actually, on the ASP board. So we're going to solder those together. The purple one on the AS board is actually going to solder to my black one on my ASP board, and the red one is actually going to solder to the red one. Now the ASP board, we're actually going to be hooking up to the left-hand side. So next we're going to go ahead and wire our XLR connector. Now it's important to note that some of you guys probably don't have XLR connectors on your equipment, you have RCAs. Don't worry, at the end, we will convert that to RCA for those of you that need it. But for right now, we need to hook up our XLR connection. Now, An XLR connection is a balanced connection, so it will have both a positive, a negative, and a ground. But once we strip back this particular sleeve off of this wire, you're going to notice that there is no black wire. Instead, it's just a bunch of loose wires in there. Just take those loose wires, twist them together, and solder them to pin one. Now, number 8 on my J3 connector is a red wire. Now, that red wire is considered our signal positive. Now, that signal positive is going to be soldered to number 2. And then, of course, the last wire, which is our white wire, will be connected to 3. The ASP board also has a wire that's going to connect, which we're going to connect right now, your binding post on the amplifier. So with this, you have a couple options. You can try to solder to that. That's not a great thing to solder to. So another thing is you can crimp connect these on there. Problem is these particular cables are very short that Ghent Audio gives you. You have a hard time crimping something on there and getting it to really fit. Now, one thing to take note of is when you do the binding post, it does come with some plastic washers. You do want those between the case and the nut before you tighten that down. Now, the ASP200 is completely wired, and you don't have much left. You only have the AS200, and really, what's left is very simple. You have one wire, which is going to connect, once again, to your binding post on the right-hand side this time, and you also have your XLR connector, which is going to connect just like we connected the other one. Now, it's important to note that all those other cables that are connected to the AS module, we're not using, so you can just cut those off. Believe it or not, you're done. I mean, you have just made a high fidelity amplifier, and what probably took you under 2 hours to do. And I mean, that's unreal. So you're talking about a savings of $2,700 for just a couple hours worth of time. And for you that are really good with electronics, it's not going to take you even close to that. So if you've built something like this before, this is going to take you a very short amount of time. Now all you have to do is plug it up and enjoy. I did mention to you that I'm going to go ahead and show you how to hook these up to RCAs. Now, in order to do that, all you have to do is go to Amazon and purchase some of these XLR to RCA cables. Now, I recommend these from Monoprice. I put a link in the description. Please check that out. I'm telling you this because I have tried other ones, and the other ones that I tried, even more expensive ones, I got shorts in on delivery. These Monoprice ones are really well made and are worth the price. Now, there's only one last thing to do, and that's to hook up your speakers and enjoy this particular hi-fi amplifier. Now, you're probably wondering what my experience is with this particular amplifier. Now, I'm going to tell you that I absolutely love this amplifier. I hooked these up to the speakers that I built when I collaborated with Kirby Meets Audio, and I gotta say, the bass never hit so hard before. I was really impressed with the amount of bass response that I got from this amplifier. It really did have a brand new effect on what my speakers sounded like. Now, the great thing about this amplifier too is it's easily stable down to 4 ohms. All right, guys, now I hope you learned something and I hope you enjoyed it. Now, if you have any questions, any comments, any concerns, throw them in the comment section below, or if you just wanna say hi, I'd appreciate that. If this is your first time to the channel, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and don't forget to ring the bell so that you get instant notification. I'd love to see you back. Until next time, I'm out.